In this video, I'm going to talk about some aspects of the electrical panel enclosures you most probably did not consider before. I will discuss the bearing system configurations, the enclosure compartments, wiring ducts, and so on. This is the following part of the electrical control panel series and their enclosures. So if you've missed the previous parts, watch them before this one. As you have seen in the previous part, the panel has a steel sheet inside, known as the mounting plate, that we have to dismantle and install some wiring ducts on that before we do anything else. Ducts are a kind of organizing component that we route the wires inside the panel using them. I'm going to add another point here about wiring ducts. As you see in this electrical control panel, in some routes we have more wires, and in some others we have fewer. So we should consider the depth and the width of every piece of wiring ducts according to the volume of the wires we're going to lay into them. It is not only about the size of the wiring ducts, but the dimensions of the enclosure have also a significant impact on the comfort of wiring and installation of the electrical components inside the panel. Obviously, the more electrical components we have to install inside the panel, the bigger the size of the electrical panel should be. In addition to the number of the components, the purpose of usage can also impact the size, type, and configuration of the enclosure. Generally, an electrical panel enclosure is comprised of a chassis or frame and some plates on its different sides that can be dismantled and assembled pretty easily to provide different configurations known as enclosure bearing systems. Let me give you an example. Consider this motor control center or MCC panel. This panel has three separate compartments with different dimensions that are attached to each other. The left one contains the mains power bus bars. The middle enclosure consists of several other compartments, each one assigned to a circuit breaker of a specific electric motor. These circuit breakers take the power from the bus bars, and in the right-hand side compartment, the cables will be connected to the output of the circuit breakers and transfer the power to the electric motor terminal box. This electrical MCC panel is actually a kind of side bearing system in that separate panels are connected side by side. As you see here, depending on our requirements, there could be other bearing system configurations as well. In these systems, as all of the enclosures are connected to each other, they have potential equalization and therefore provide more safety, and we do not have to earth each of them individually. Generally, there are standard dimensions for the industrial panel enclosures that we can choose among them when we are designing our electrical panel. However, you might see some custom size enclosures in particular applications, such as these freestanding VFD or variable frequency drive panels. We can also choose one-door or two-door panels depending on the width of the panel and our desire. As all of the electrical panels have a metal enclosure accommodating many electrical and non-electrical devices, they are pretty heavy most of the time. Therefore, to lift, move, or install them using a crane, the enclosure manufacturers consider lifting eyebolts directly on top of the frame corners. After the placement of the panel in its final position, we should fix them in there by bolting their bottom frames to the ground. We talked almost about every aspect of the electrical and control panel enclosures, except the color. Same as the other properties of the panel, the color also has a standard. Basically, the color of the enclosures is determined by the RAL standard color code, which is a 4-digit number. For instance, this electrical panel has the RAL 7035 light gray color. That's it for this video. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to click the like button and share this video with your friends and colleagues.